Feedback from these people at these events, it takes them a while to respond. And, you know, they need some time to think about it and filter it through their own kind of thinking process. And I think by having a website where you invite people to reflect, and their reflection can be in form of text, their reflection can be in form of audio recording, or it can be a video that they recorded from the camera on their computer, so that they can actually add their comments maybe later on. Maybe it takes them a couple of days to kind of digest everything that they said. Maybe they took down a bunch of notes, and sometimes a week later or a month later. And just keep this open, because what it does is it allows you to collect some data as far as what worked, what didn't work, what worked for some groups, what worked for other groups, and allows you to kind of create a program that makes more sense in the years to come. Another thing too, I think would be a great idea, is to maybe take a segment of the students that come here and really spend a day or two showing them how to document this events like this. How do you document stories? How do you document concerns? How do you document changes over the years, so that the school board membership could take a look at this stuff, and also make it available for others to take a look at these stories and comments and concerns that people have. I think that one of the things that I talked about was, what kind of pathway are we building for our school communities that allows ideas to kind of move and exist freely? And I think that this is a step in that right direction. So I challenge all of you to share your thoughts about the conference.